And now we're just going to even the mirror bell up, otherwise she'll go out lopsided. I got taught the importance of rhythm by a very old osteopath. He was 96 when I finished working with him. But he talked about how the body liked rhythm. And as you know, the heart has a rhythm. The intestines has a rhythm, we call it peristalsis. The lungs have a rhythm. If we get anxious, for example, the first thing we do is change our breathing. But to be relaxed, the body likes rhythm. So the breathing likes to be in a rhythmical fashion. When it's all over the place and erratic, same as the heart, we're starting to get into stress. So once you can bring rhythm to the body in this sort of fashion, the body actually likes it a lot. Again, working through this meridian that I told you about, the gallbladder meridian. And we're just bringing circulation to these areas. If you touch an area of the body, you will start to improve circulation in that area. Because the body likes human touch. Think of cuddling a new baby. It not only feels good for you, but it feels good for the baby. And it's because those sensory nerve endings are picking up information, and the body just naturally starts to send circulation there. That's why when a mum has a child who falls over, and mum rubs the bit that hurts or just holds the area, the child feels less pain straight away. I'm just working through these gluteal muscles, as I said. And none of this needs to be aggressive, because pregnant women are amazing. They tend to like to be treated. It's almost like the body surrenders and says, yes, I'd like a little bit of help. And if you think of all the work that it's doing, whether it's from providing mum and baby with oxygen, filtering the toxins, as I said, with the liver and the kidneys, to absorbing nutrients for two, the extra stress on the joints and the muscles, especially around the pelvis, and the emotional things that are going on. You know, there's a new person just about to enter the world. That plays on your mind. Are they going to be okay? Am I going to be okay? And all of this stuff is normal and natural. Just loosening through the vertebra, because all of these vertebrae go off to different organs. So the brain and spinal cord comes down, the nerves go off to different areas of the body. For example, the upper part's more the lung and the heart, this area is more the digestion, and this area is more the pelvis. So we're just trying to normalize and maximize good nerve and blood supply. And that's what osteopathy is all about. Under here is the spleen. And the spleen is for reproducing new blood cells once they've had their time. Blood cells normally last around 120 days before they die off and are replenished. And those parts are sent to the spleen to be reproduced as new blood cells. And as a mum and a woman about to go into birth, you need your spleen to be efficient for your immune system and your blood. Very simple. I'm just going to bring you backwards just a little. And when I find an area that's tense or tight, like just in through here, I'll just stay on that for a few more seconds. today, although Mirabelle's had some back pain, I'm doing a normal general treatment just for health. Because around this time, you know, you want things to be as normal as they can be so that baby comes when expected. Uterus is in good shape and getting plenty of good fresh blood and good nerve supply and great drainage of the lymph. So this just starts to help bring the pelvis and the body back to health. Today, unfortunately, we focus on disease so much, we never really give people a treatment for health. And for me, that's our biggest mistake. Ironically, when you forget about disease and start to provide health to an area, things start to improve. Thank you.
I guess there's so much more I have to learn. But if you're here with me, I know which way to turn. You always give me somewhere I can run. You may